American Towman TV.
Hi everyone, and welcome to Tow Expo Dallas 2019. I'm your host, Emily Oz of American Towman TV. We're thrilled to have you here in Texas with us. The following program will feature all the details about what's available here at the convention, including training, events, and the amazing show floor experience.
Over 100 exhibitors are here at the Gaylord Texan Resort, armed with the latest tools and technology to increase the efficiency, safety, and volume of your business. Exhibit hall hours are the same for both Friday and Saturday, 11 o'clock a.m. to 5 o'clock p.m. Let's begin our special events and hospitality schedule in order of when they'll happen, starting with Thursday, August 15th. Let's kick off a fun weekend with the Big Smoke, sponsored by Auto Return and Police Towers of America. There's a free shuttle being provided from here at the resort to the Tap-In Grill and Pub located in downtown Grapevine on Main Street. The Big Smoke starts at 8 o'clock p.m. until 10 o'clock. Enjoy a free cigar with towing friends. And now let's take a look at Friday, August 16th. The show floor grand opening takes place at 11 o'clock today. And from 12 o'clock noon until 4 o'clock p.m., there are free mini clinics in the Longhorn Exhibit Hall Mini Clinic Theater. Here's a list of clinics. Learn something new from the experts for free, including light duty showcases from NRC Industries at 1:30 and Jerdan at 3:45. At 12 o'clock, the towers roll in environmental cleanup services. 12:45, defensive driving for the tow operator. 1:30, NRC product showcase. 2:15, why your tow shop should be texting 2019. At 3 o'clock, the legislative update. And at 3:45, Jerdan light duty showcase. Learn how to tow the latest in luxury vehicles. Brush up on these skills with free education classes courtesy of Allstate Roadside Services, offered 3 times during show floor hours both Friday and Saturday in booth 1233. During show floor hours both days, you can check out the USA Wrecker Pageant. Get a good look at some of the best wreckers on the road. And your children in attendance can visit booth 1141 for the Kids Corral, sponsored by Geico, to get face paint, balloon pets, and to color. Then at 5 o'clock, just as the show floor is closing, please join us for 10 Gallon Gala, which offers free entertainment, including a casino, games, country line dancing, and much more. And finally, here's the rundown of special events for the final day of Tow Expo Dallas, Saturday, August 17th. Again today, from 12 noon to 4 o'clock, there are free mini clinics in the Longhorn Exhibit Hall Mini Clinic Theater. Here's a list of clinics. Learn something new from the experts for free, including a light-duty showcase from Miller Industries at 3 o'clock. At 12 o'clock, the towers roll in environmental cleanup services. At 1 o'clock, create a positive image for your towing company. 2 o'clock, roadway safety. 3 o'clock, Miller Industries Light Duty Showcase. To wrap up a great expo, please join us for a bite and a brew as we wrap up the show and celebrate 23 years of Tow Expo Dallas. Enjoy free Texas barbecue and saddle up for a cold beer located in the Longhorn Hall along the roadway. And stick around for the USA Wrecker Pageant Ceremony. Starts at 4:30 in the Longhorn Hall Mini Clinic area. See who takes home top honors in each category of the amazing Wrecker Pageant.
We'll be right back with the details on all the learning opportunities here at Tow Expo Dallas. You don't want to miss the latest and greatest seminars here at the show. But first, let's take a look at one of the recent videos featured on American Towman TV. A whale of a tale.
Generate more cash calls. Use Google Ads to show up at the top of any search. OMG Crush. decade search done smart.
Recovery Roundup, brought to you by OMG Tow Marketing.
Hi, I'm Emily Oz for Tow Industry Week. On this edition, we have a whale of a story, straight from the mouth of an Alaskan towman.
Just when you thought you've seen it all in the towing industry, then you see this. Webb's Towing and Recovery out of Anchorage, Alaska, helping biologists tow a dead whale off the beach and away to a research facility. The whale was last seen alive in the bay, but for reasons unclear at this point, the animal didn't make it back out to bigger seas and died close to shore. And now meet Nick Webb, who can tell you all about the towman's whale tale in his own words, the day we caught up with him in Las Vegas at American Towman Showplace.
It was quite odd to get a call about a whale. I didn't expect to get that one. We got a phone call from a local biologist because they had talked to a crane company, but the crane said that because it was 200 feet away off the beach, that they would need a gigantic crane to reach out 200 feet to pick up this whale that my equipment might be better suited for them. So they asked us to if we could help out with this, and we told them, yeah, we can go help out with that. So we went the next day at low tide.
Webb drove his 60-ton rotator to the scene, a Century 1060S on a Peterbilt.
Well, it was kind of all a guessing game. They guesstimated that the whale was about 3 years old, which is a juvenile in whale terms, I guess. It was 30 feet long, and they figured it was anywhere from 20 to 25,000 pounds, where a full-grown whale is like 40-some feet long and 66,000 pounds. So it was about halfway from a full size where they can be, but it was really just a guess on what it was. They wanted us to relocate the whale from where it was on the beach to a more manageable place where the local natives could harvest it and do what they needed to do with it, and so they could go, so nothing would go to waste. The local biologists and stuff, they wanted the whale head so that it could be shipped off to be scanned and researched to see, one, like why did it beach itself twice before it passed away? Was it sick? One of the things they wanted to figure out was how it hears. So it was, everyone was super excited about it. It was above my head, but they were all excited about it. But they wanted the head for research. It was gonna go, once we got it up on the beach and onto a trailer, it was gonna go to a local fish processing plant to be frozen, and then it was getting on the barge to be shipped down to California.
Webb describes the challenges of such a task.
One, the smell, because it had already been sitting there for 2 days. So the smell wasn't great, wasn't terrible, but it wasn't great. And then just, where can I hook onto a whale? I mean, I know where to hook onto tractor trailers and stuff like that, but so one was the tail, obvious choice. Hooked one line to the tail, and then I ended up having them cut a hole in the lower part of the jaw so I could wrap around some bone. Just trying to find strong parts that wasn't gonna mess with their research stuff, but yet still strong enough where it was still gonna come up the hill. By the time I'd got there, they'd worked all day the day before to try and get the head separated from the body. They got about halfway through, and they kind of needed the whale to roll or stretch out and be in a little different spot. So once I started relocating it up the hill, and it was kind of stretching apart a little bit, then they could finish cutting it. And it cut pretty easy with they just used big fillet knives basically and cut the rest of it. And then once it was separated, then I relocated the body up the beach a little more, and then I brought the head up the rest of the way to the parking lot where we were sitting. Yeah, it was a privilege to be a part of it, and definitely an interesting story I get to tell.
It sure is. Thanks, Nick. And if you have an interesting recovery you want to submit for coverage on American Towman TV, please visit recoveryroundup.com for details.
Now let's take a look at some of the learning opportunities for you here in Texas.
You gain access to all conferences with the Intel Passport, which costs $195 here on site. Our prestigious conference schedule running Thursday, Friday, and Saturday includes courses in towing and recovery, business operations, building revenue, insurance, and police towers. And catch special workshops presented by the Texas Department of Licensing and Registration. And remember, the annual Southwest Tow Operators Legislative Meeting is on Sunday, August 18th from 8:30 a.m. until 1 o'clock p.m., located in Fort Worth Meeting Rooms 6 and 7. For a complete listing of the seminars, visit the registration booth at the Expo for a pamphlet, or visit towexpodfw.com online anytime, where you can find a list, explanation, and times of every seminar.
Thanks for joining us here in the Lone Star State. Enjoy the Gaylord Texan Resort and all the hospitality offered to you by the staff at American Towman. We're so happy to have you with us.
Now let's toss it to a recent episode of American Towman TV featuring our Recovery Roundup series.
American Towman TV.
Hi, I'm Emily Oz for Tow Industry Week. It's another edition of Recovery Roundup, where we feature towing's power players take on heavy-duty jobs with expertise.
With over 21 million views to his YouTube channel, there are a lot of loyal followers of the work of Ron Pratt of Midwest Truck Sales and Service of Scott City, Missouri.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Ron Pratt Channel. I am Ron, also known as Rotator Ron by a lot of my viewers.
A third-generation family business, this proud towman wears a GoPro video camera mounted on his helmet and records entire jobs featuring his Miller fleet. The main truck is their Century 1150 R Rotator on a Peterbilt. He also works a Vulcan V70 35-ton unit on a Western Star and a Century 4024 20-ton wrecker on a Peterbilt. Pratt believes his channel is very popular because it's family-friendly and showcases the professionalism, and may we add skill, he is known for.
We are gonna use both trucks. This thing has got 200 bushels of grain still in the hopper. All right, everybody clear?
Yep.
Also unique to Ron's channel is the fact that in Missouri, tow operators are respectfully referred to as emergency personnel, so Pratt will run his red and blue lights and sirens out to calls when necessary.
Let's go see what's going on.
For this edition of Recovery Roundup, we called him up to hear about the most popular video on his channel, 1.6 million views of the recovery of this semi loaded with cottonseed.
When we got the initial call from the police department, we had reports of a tractor with a loaded grain trailer that had crossed through the median, was initially headed northbound, crossed through the median, took out some of the barrier cable system, crossed through the northbound lane of traffic, and had come to rest in a fence row on the west side of the interstate after it had crossed over the northbound lane. And it was headed north on the southbound side of the interstate. So it wasn't blocking traffic, but it was going to be a heavy pull because they were afraid the fuel tanks had ruptured and there was some grain spillage.
The semi driver had blown a steer tire and the trailer was heavily damaged.
So we had no way to steer the unit and the tractor was heavily damaged. Since it was not blocking the road, we were very, very close to an exit ramp headed southbound. And my initial plan, I wanted to be able to turn the 1150R around and pull the unit out the direction it was headed because it was already headed north, which would have put us heading the wrong direction on the shoulder of the interstate. Unfortunately, the powers that be on scene did not like that approach, so we had to turn the entire truck and trailer 180 degrees so that it was facing south again, which for a unit that doesn't steer and is completely loaded can be quite difficult. We were able to get it turned around, but then the most difficult part of all of it was getting it back over the crest of the shoulder without opening those hoppers and losing all the grain.
Rim slings made of synthetic fabric were used on the tires to help move the job forward.
Synthetic rope has taken a hold in the industry, and rim slings specifically are almost a staple for anybody that owns a rotator or a heavy towing and recovery vehicle. They're designed to use with aluminum wheels as lifting points. You run them through the holes in the aluminum wheels and you lift with them. But as most towers, towing and recovery operators will do, they find other uses for almost anything that you have in your toolbox. On this job, I used two of the 3/4 inch, rim slings on each of the two steering tires. Since we didn't have any steering capabilities on this truck, I used them through the steering wheels and put one winch cable through each set so that I could control the movement of the truck. And being as it was as buried as it was, the truck weighed approximately 83,000 pounds. Most of your grain haulers are going to run a little bit over the 80,000 mark, but you're dealing with resistances over 160 if it's buried down below the tires, which this one was at one point. And then once you get it rolling, even with the brakes not functioning properly, you're still dealing with over 100,000 pounds of resistance. And the rim slings do a wonderful, wonderful job. We were able to do the entire recovery using just the rim slings and the winches on the rotator and the 4024. The most challenging, I would say, was getting the trailer up over the crest of the shoulder without opening up the hoppers. Such a steep angle. We did several things. We built ramps, wooden ramps. We were pulling sideways and pulling forward at the same time with the trailer because the trailer was wanting to lean. It was on such an incline. And sometimes wood cribbing is your best friend. You just build ramps and walk it up. And that's what we ended up doing.
Thanks, Ron. We'll be featuring more of Pratt's recovery work here on ATTV in the future. Now, if you would like to submit your recovery to be featured on the Roundup, please visit recoveryroundup.com. Thanks for watching. We love to hear from our viewers. If you have a suggestion or story idea for American Towman TV, please email us at ozattv@gmail.com. You can see our weekly videos released on towindustryweek.com, the industry's leading e-news magazine.
Generate more 5-star reviews. Take control of your online reputation. OMG Tow Marketing's partner program, reviews, directories, social media.
And remember, everyone, the next American Towman Convention will be held in Atlantic City the first week of December. Join us for the American Towman Exposition as we check out America's favorite playground together. Visit atexposition.com for info.